whistle. Offside is the call. Here in the late going of the frame, New York's ahead 1-0. Swift Currents won the draw in the neutral zone. They fail to capitalize on the man advantage, and they still trail by a goal.
Well, that's a missed opportunity, James. An opportunity to get the equalizer. Oh,
scores! The captain comes through! Some last-second communication before both teams get ready to drop the puck here. Sneaks away with the puck after he was tangled up on the draw. Sends the pass over. New York's trying to make something happen in the offensive zone. Oh, and he lines up his opponent perfectly with the hip check. Denies him in close.
Now the shooter's going to run out of real estate because he does a great job of getting out of top of the crease and taking away all the room. When you make yourself as big as possible, there's less holes in the net.
And that'll put a bow on the first 20 minutes of action here tonight. We've got lots more still to come. Second period is just around the corner. Well, let's see what period two has in store for us as they are about to drop the puck. You can tell we're in for a good one because almost every fan is in their seats here as we are still tied with the second getting underway. Close save, and he handles it with ease. There's the whistle as the goalie hangs on. Tempers flaring after the whistle here.
Everyone knows you can't shoot the puck after the whistle, James. There's traffic in front. It can be dangerous. But what it's doing, it's getting under the skin of your opponent. And that's exactly what his intentions were.
And here come the Zebras, Cheryl.
Yeah, they jump in right when the guys are getting tired. They see their spot, they take it, and the guys are heading to the box now, 5-minute major. They make their way over to the penalty box, still chirping one another. You can see that it was testy out there, but they'll go back to the box, and they'll sit for five.
The gloves are back on, the buckets are strapped back in, and we still got a game to play here with an upcoming faceoff. Score! And the deadlock is broken as they take the lead.
Well, that's a huge shift. You can see everyone standing up on the bench. They know how much it means, but it's the next shift that matters most now, James. You want to kind of push and put pressure on your opponent when they're down.
New York's won the faceoff at center. Feeds the puck to Rally. New York's got the puck. Here he is in close!
Trying to find a way to get ahead and on top, you have to trust the process. That's exactly what they've done, and they've been rewarded for it.
And off the draw, they win the faceoff. And he loses both the puck and his balance after that hit. to make something happen inside the neutral zone. Takes the puck at the point. Oh, he stops him with the glove. Great reflexes there. Lots of hockey left to be played in this period. You can feel the energy in this crowd. It's a tie game. Off the draw, and he ties up his opponent. Handles the puck. New York's crossed the line and on the attack. And now it's to Fane. Grabs the puck at center. Quick feed down low. Moves the puck along the half wall. An easy glove save made by Shesterkin. Inching closer to the midway mark of the period. We are all tied up in this one. And from off the wing, he comes up with it with both centers scrummed up. The Broncos move the puck in the defensive zone. And he takes the pass. Look out, here they come on the attack. New York's got the puck in their own end. And that's picked off. Oh, he targeted his opponent and delivers a perfect hip check. Play blown dead, let's get the call.
That's going to be a slashing call. Anytime you come over the top or you hit the equipment and the ref is there, you're going to get a 2-minute penalty.
New York sending their power play unit out for the first time tonight.
They haven't scored on the power play yet, but they have another opportunity. The key to this one, gain possession so they can set up.
And they've gone in front thanks to the power play goal.
Well, it's all about manipulating the PK, and that's what they did so well to take advantage of that opportunity. Well, he gets all of this one, and you know that players, they can shoot off 1 foot from behind them, in front of them, but this one's teed up perfectly right in his wheelhouse, and he gets all of it.
Nice stick work to knock the puck loose. The Broncos gain possession in their own end. To the low slot! Oh, to Nyssen with the paddle save!
Ross has been engaged physically throughout this game, and he just served a 5-minute major for fighting, but you got to find a way to be physical, engaged, and generate opportunities like he did just there.
Can't hang on to the biscuit after that. Tremendous hip check on the play. Oh, big time blocker stopped by Shesterkin. We got a penalty coming up here on the play. There's the whistle, and here's the goal.
Well, the coach isn't going to be happy with this penalty. You have a 1-goal lead, and now you find yourself back on your heels, and the penalty kill has to come out and do a job.
Current's got another opportunity here on the man advantage.
Power plays are a funny thing, especially when you're down by one, James. You have to act as if you are the hunter, and you have to possess that puck and attack.
Scores! And they convert on the power play.
Well, they drew the penalty because they were competing and they were urgent on the puck, James, and then the same approach came on the power play where they knew how to hound it and retrieve it, and guess what? They're rewarded for their efforts.
More than half the frame has been played here. It's all tied up. Hicks wins the draw at center. Reads it perfectly and comes up with the takeaway. Big play inside the defensive zone. Slides it over with pace to Cappy. New York's looking to break out of their own end. Puck picked up by Crosby. They gain possession here inside the neutral zone. We got a whistle. Penalty coming up.
3 penalties in 1 period. You got to stay disciplined. And what it does is it disrupts the flow of your bench. Only your PKers are getting out of there. I won't be surprised to see the 1-3-1 again. They had success on it earlier, James. And listen, I love this. I coach this with my team because I love the bumper spot and I love the net front flare. You're taking away the eyes of the goaltender, but he can also pop out below the goal line and present as an option. So multiple variations that can strike.
Scores! Putting the special in special teams, they take the lead.
And often when you're on special teams, James, that it can go either way in terms of the momentum. If you don't generate anything, it goes the other way. If you generate something, it's all
throws it to Datsun. Oh, what a hip check on the old school variety. Beautiful. Quick feed to Fane. Slides the puck down low. Jordan's playing it on the line. Let's see what the officials are calling.
Now you got to toe the line. You can play with an edge, but you certainly can't play frustrated and take penalties consistently. That's the second of the period.
Offense is on faceoff, and he wins the draw. From one point man to another. Oh, my goodness, it's Stata. What a save!
It was all but in, James, and that athleticism and the will to get to that puck, that was on display. Oh, no, there he goes again, James. It's the second time this period, and it's real tough to get into a rhythm on your bench when you consistently take penalties.
A little four-on-four hockey as both teams step inside the faceoff circle.
Four-on-four, you want to utilize north, south, east, west, and capitalize on the speed with the extra ice available. You can bet your coaching staff is going to put some pretty quick players out there.
Swift Current's got it in their own zone.
Shesterkin's been so impressive, in particular in that last sequence, James, and he is out of gas. It didn't prevent him from making that save, but now he's going to get some much-needed rest as that puck heads out of his zone.
Here in the late goings of the period, New York's been the better-looking team over the last few minutes. They'd love to build on this one-goal lead. And as he skates back out onto the ice, it's a brief power play. They'll have to go to work here. Slides it quickly to Jordan. They can't convert on the power play. They still trail in this one.
Fane's been so dangerous tonight. He's got two in the game. You know he's looking for the hottie.
New York's got a hold of it against the wall. Grabs the puck in the defensive zone. Cody's across the line now and on the attack in the offensive end. The point goal! How did he stop that one? Off a stick and they can't connect. And he hangs on just as time runs out. There's the horn bringing period number two to an end. 40 minutes down, 20 to go. Third period action is coming up. Both teams seem fresh after that second intermission. We're ready to drop the puck on period number three. Puck is dropped on the third, and if you love offense, well, stick around for this one. Well, Pounder, we've played more than 40 minutes now in this one. How do you view things?
New York's in the lead here in the third period, James, but this has been an action-packed, back-and-forth, entertaining game that just screams offense. I would have hated it. Why?
Scores! They tied it up! Back to even.
Well, working hard, sticking to the game plan with good habits, and they're back to even.
Still plenty of time left in this frame. The next goal could be a big one as we are tied. Wilson's won it. The Broncos have a hold of it in the defensive zone. Here's a short pass to Wilson. Easily turned aside by Hoffman. Oh, textbook hip check. He got all of that one. Perfectly executed hip check there.
Freeze it.
Takes the feed from his netminder. Moves it quickly over to Datsyuk. Reaches out and uses the stick. New York's got the puck in the corner. The Broncos get a hold of the puck in their own end. Tried to get too cute with it and loses possession.
Ross is all skills. You know that back in the day, he's been working on it collectively, and it shows in his game. But right here, he just gets caught up in a tight space and loses the puck.
Quick pass to Datsu. Answered the call on that play.
As a goaltender, you have to be able to read and anticipate the play. He does it perfectly and is able to negate the shot.
The pass in front! Oh, and they can't connect on the pass because it was broken at the cross.
He's in tight to the net, James, and he knows that he's not going to have much time or space to get it off, so he elects to use the snapshot and beats the goaltender.
The Rush have come out like gangbusters here to start this third period, taking a one-goal lead.
Yeah, and you don't want to change that mindset. I mean, they've held the puck. They've had the majority of possession, showing their calm and poise with it, James, waiting for the opportunity to attack the net. They just got to continue to do that, and they'll be successful.
Looking to make something happen on the boards. What a steal in his own end. Good reach for the stick to knock the puck away. Swift Current's got possession of the puck. Grabs the puck. And that's off a stick. Here's a sharp angle shot. Turn that chance aside. Rallies, moving the puck through his own zone. And he takes the feed. Keeps a hold of the puck after that knock. And he easily stops that one. There's the whistle. We'll get a face-off after the goalie covers up.
Pastrnak's a competitor who never gives up on a play, guys. His contortionist zone ability is what he makes those athletic all-out stops to keep the puck from going in his net.
Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Oh, and he throws a perfectly executed hip check there. Hip check, he lined it up perfectly. And he somehow gets a piece of it with the glove to keep it out.
As a goaltender, you want to make yourself as big as possible, and that's exactly what he does right there and just takes away the net.
Past the midway mark in this period. If you love offense, this has been the game for you. 5-4 is what... Swift Currents won it, now they'll go on the attack. And that shot dies in traffic. Oh, and he delivers a thunderous hit check from behind the net. From off the wall and onto a stick. And play rolls on as he came up with a nice stop there. Thunderous hit check on the play.
Longer there, James. They're running out of runway, but they found a way to get it done. You got to come up big at the right moment, embrace the pressure, and that's exactly what they did.
Swift Currents made this anybody's hockey game now. We are all tied just the way we love it, Cheryl.
Yeah, everyone loves it in the building. I mean, the energy that it's created and the buzz. You can see everyone on the bench. They were up cheering, and this is the momentum switch in the game. This face-off is critical. You want possession. You want to continue to drive the pace and put them on their heels.
A big face-off here inside the offensive end. Datsyuk's gained possession, and his great work inside the face-off circle pays off again. And he coughs it up with the pass. Moves it to the middle. What a chance, but they can't connect. And they continue to apply pressure here. Moves it to Cappy. Swift Currents cut it along the wall. Picked up along the boards by Wilson. Here's a shot. Oh, and he steps up with the glove to stop that one. Late goings of this period. We got a tie game. Wilson's won the draw. Oh, tried to pick his corner and puts it off the outside of the post.
I like the habits and the shot selection right there, James, but it goes off of the pipe, doesn't go in the 4x6, and now they're chasing the game.
Quick feed to Ross. Makes his presence known on the ice. Oh, what a hit check. He got all of that. Less than 60 seconds left here in the final frame. Swift Current's got the puck. Here's a chance to get it out of their own end. Good heads up play to keep the puck in the offensive zone. Big time hit check there. That's how you finish a play. Takes possession. Moves the pass in front. And that goes off someone in front. Here's a shot. Score! Stop going.
Margin of error here, and he's able to find the back of the net. It's all about accuracy, not necessarily how hard the shot is.
Officials ready to drop the puck and get things back underway. That's it. There's the final horn to close this one up. Well, this thing started with a whole lot of bangs, and then it kind of just turned into a chess match here.
Yeah, really dried up in terms of the offense the last 40 minutes, and both teams just really shutting down in the neutral zone, not allowing a lot to go north and protecting the middle of the ice. Kind of dry game, my kind of style.
From all of us here at EA Sports, I'm James Cebulski. See ya! We'll be right back. out of bounds on both blue lines here, and we are about set to drop the puck here at center. And this one is officially underway with the puck dropping. Along the right wall and into the offensive end. Puts it on net, gets in front of it. Goaltender covers it up, and we'll get a reset here. We're still in the early stages of this period. Still no score in this one. Swoops in and grabs the puck with the centers tied up in the scrum on the draw. Takes the feed. Takes a shot! And that goes off a stick somewhere in traffic. Swift Current's got it in their own zone. Fires it on net with the stop.
He really owns the crease when he drops into that butterfly positioning. And for the shooter, I think it's intimidating. He makes himself as big as possible. And everyone knows he's athletic to boot.
Swift Current's got a hold of it along the wall. And that's a great read to force the turnover. Here in the corner, he grabs the puck.
Wow, what an incredible shift. They're so urgent all over the offensive zone. Coaches love these types of shifts. Be aware of your surroundings and have your head on a swivel. He isn't, and he takes a huge hit.
Big face-off coming up here in the offensive zone.
Well, after that last shift with sustained pressure, you know that the goaltender is fatigued. You got to find ways to get pucks to the net.
And that caroms off a body in traffic. Looks to get the puck over to Cappy. Throws it in. Oh, and he lines up his opponent perfectly with a hit check. Can't get it to go. Swift Current's got possession here in the offensive zone. Ross will play it to the corner. From off the boards, takes the feed inside the zone. Along the half wall with the puck. Here's a short pass to Dillon. Sharp angle shot. Shesterkin's going to hang on to the puck for a whistle. Getting closer to the halfway point of this frame. We've still got zeros on the board. And there's a little boost from off the wing. Scores! And they tuck it into the back of the net
there, James. I think they waved this off immediately. This goal is not going to count.
Faceoff coming up here, and they certainly look hungry to answer back after that non-goal call. And he takes possession of the puck from off the wing with the centers all locked up there off the draw. Takes the feed. Latimer's got it in the corner. Now a quick pass to Recchi. Comes up with the steal. The Warriors take possession in the defensive end. Gaining momentum along the wing. Centering pass! And he denies that great opportunity there. Well past the midway mark of this period. Still scoreless in this one. Dillon's won the faceoff, and now let's see what they can do. Oh, look at the glove save by Shesterkin. Officials have got both teams ready, and it looks like play is set to resume here. Play resumes as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Ross plays it against the boards. Moose Jaw's got the puck now. The Broncos ready to go on the attack. Oh, another great save right there! And a good read to get possession there with the two centermen tangled up. Moose Jaw sliding the puck behind the net. Poked away. Oh, he targeted his opponent and delivers a perfect hip check. Loves the puck into the corner of the offensive zone. Swift Current's looking to break out. Tremendous hip check on the play. And the puck skips away after a nice defensive deflection. Moves it over to Hicks. A little back and forth. Slides the puck over. Handles it again.
No mistake, as he usually does.
Moose Jaw's got to be feeling good about getting that goal here late in the first, Cheryl.
Yeah, I like the energy that they created for their bench even before the goal. James, they started to pressure, and that's something that I noticed. There was a change late in the first.
Moose it quickly over to Ross. Here's a chance. Oh, the pipe! Faceoff coming up as the puck goes up and over the glass. Getting into the later stages of this period, the Warriors have taken a 1-0 lead. Moose Jaw's got possession here at their own end. Quick pass to Dillon. Puck picked up in the open ice. Can't stay on his feet after that hit. Oh, what a hip check on the old school variety. Beautiful. Takes it in front. Nice defensive robbery on that. Grabs it in his own end. Come on the attack. Tosses it on to Dillon. Moves it to Latimer. Moose Jaw's got a hold of the puck now. Swift Current's looking to break out of their own end. Trying to make a move and the puck hops away. Centers gliding up to the faceoff dots here. There's the horn. Still 40 more minutes left in regulation time. We'll get to the second period right after this. And the official seems about ready to drop the puck on period number two. Second frame is underway as the puck is dropped. They put the puck into the offensive end. Oh, what a hit. He got all of that hip check. Quick feed to Dillon. Oh, the officials were all over that trip. And let's see what the definitive call is on the ice.
Well, everyone has a role in this PK unit, knows that they not only have to kill this penalty off and keep the game within reach, but maybe they can be opportunistic and pounce on a loose puck for an opportunity.
Moose Jaw's going to start with the puck inside the offensive zone. In front of the net, the goaltender covers up for a whistle on the play. Power play set to roll on as the centers get ready for the faceoff. And they take possession. Nice job tangling him up on the draw. And they get that puck down the ice. Moose Jaw's got the puck along the wall. Gets it over to Latimer. And he takes the feed. Into the corner of the attacking area. Takes the pass and works the cycle down low. Here's a short pass to Dillon. Tries to get this man advantage going from their own end now. Gets the full use of his stick on the poke check. Swift Current's got a hold of the puck. Trying to get it out. And he's able to move the puck across the blue line and out of harm's way. Both sides back to even strength.
Well, the power play had a ton of ozone possession time, but it was all perimeter. They didn't find ways to move the coverage. It was easy as a PK unit to stand in that box formation and not move. You have to find ways to create some motion and pull the coverage inside the dots.
Swift Current's got the puck along the boards. The Warriors are in transition. Cappy's got it in the defensive zone. Trying to get it down the ice, and his teammate comes up with it. And the puck leaves the offensive zone. They'll be forced to tag up. Fires it. Oh, he got a little sliver of it, and it stays out.
Shesterkin's got great rebound control and just pushes that out of harm's way.
Moosejaw's got the puck in the defensive end. Swift Current's got control of it now from their own end. We've got icing on the play. Faceoff coming up. Still lots of time left in the period. 1-0 the score. Off the draw, and a nice job locking up his opponent. Moves it quickly over to Ross. Knocked away in the offensive zone. Great chance and an even better save.
Man, is he ever known for this. When he drops into that butterfly positioning, he makes himself as big as possible. So tough to beat because there is no net available.
Broken up at center by Latimer. Great defensive effort with the stick. Pass it through. And that's stopped. More than half the period has expired. Moosejaw's up 1-0. And they win the draw on their own end. Quick pass to Hicks. Broken up with a stick in the defensive zone. Picking up some steam at center ice. Still has possession. Moosejaw's playing it from the side. The Broncos gain control of the puck. Oh, textbook! Hip check, he got all of that one. Perfectly executed hip check there. Oh, and he throws a perfectly executed hip check there. The centermen glide into position. They take possession as he locks them up off the faceoff. Makes a move in front. Denies him.
Reaction time is everything when you're a goaltender, and that's why you see from a young age them working on all of those different drills to help them with these kinds of saves. Just flash the leather and make the save. What a glove hand.
Hicks has got possession. Let's see what they can do with it now. Too much traffic in the lane. Oh, what a hip check. He lined it up perfectly. Came up with the save on that play. The Warriors have it now. There's the whistle icing the call.
Oh, James, he took a huge hit there. We'll have to have another look at that one, but looks like he's having a hard time getting up.
A critical face-off looming here, and let's see if they can maintain that offensive momentum.
Well, you know that the defensive side is vulnerable right now with a tired tender, and on the offensive side, you got to recognize that vulnerability, and you have to attack the net.
Swift Currents gain possession along the boards. Hicks plays the puck. Here's an offensive chance. Moves it to Hicks. Thunderous hit check on the play. Swatted away with the stick in the defensive zone. Moosejaw's got a hold of it against the wall. Gets a hold of the puck from the right side. And that goes off a player. And offside, we'll get a reset here. Centers are lined up, and we are ready to resume. Moose Jaw's won the faceoff at center.
Shoot it.
Shot! And that brings the second period to an end. Both teams will go back to their rooms and get a quick breather. While, man, there's a lot of fans looking forward to this intermission action coming up here. Fun entertainment in store, and we've got the third period coming up in moments. Welcome back, everyone. Both teams lined up at center ice, and we are ready to get this third period underway. They have dropped the puck here in the third. Cheryl, 40 minutes in the books now played. How do you view this one?
Smith Curran's got to be better in the third period, no question about it. They've got to be more aggressive on the puck, and they've got to attack the lanes when they get the opportunity. They've had very few shots on net, and they're fortunate this is a close game. If they want to get back in it, they got to get into the offensive zone. They got to get net front presence, and they have to shoot at all costs.
They stopped that one.
Oh, he's one of the best in the game in terms of that butterfly position, and once he drops, he's so agile to be able to slide across the net.
Puck is frozen, and we get a stoppage in play. Lots of time left in this period. 1-0 is where we sit at this point. Steps in and takes the puck. Sends a pass over. Slick feed. Ross moves the puck to the corner. Scores! I got two words for you. New game.
Yeah, it certainly is, James. And who's going to come out on top on the beginning of this faceoff? You want to be able to get that puck in the offensive zone and find a way to continue to attack.
Both teams are set. They're ready to drop the puck.
Well, pass reception is also about the pass itself here, James. And when you have a great pass, you're able to handle it. You can get it off quickly.
That's a beautiful pass saved by the goalie there. Oh, what a hip check on the play. He delivered that perfectly. Receives the pass. Huge play in his own end to come up with the puck. Rally's got it in the defensive end. And we'll get a face-off after the offside call. Inching closer to the midway mark of the period. We are all tied up in this one. The Warriors get a hold of the puck off the draw. On the attack into the offensive end, right up the gut. Here's a pass down low. Picked up along the wall by Latimer. Routine save made by Shesterkin. What a great read breaking up the pass. And that's snapped away in the defensive end by Recchi. Oh, and he tracks it perfectly in the offensive end. The puck was played along the wing. Let's first go. Scores! The go-ahead goal puts them in front.
Well, and this has been trending to happen, James. They've been closing on the puck for Eve since an upward trajectory as the games progress and they find the back of the net.
Swift Current's taking a one-goal lead here in period number three.
Well, yeah, and it's a critical time here, James. They've got the go-ahead goal now. And some of the teams will say, play safe. Not me. I'm about having the puck. Stay aggressive. Stay on your toes. Make them play on their heels.
And somehow he hangs on. Moose Jaw's got it in their own zone. Tries to feed it over to Latimer. Great positioning in the defensive end.
As an athlete, you always want to try and contribute and get things going for your team, and especially when you're trailing, you want to ignite a spark. Unfortunately, though, he tried it a little too much there, and it gets taken away.
Strong defensive effort. Moose Jaw's got a hold of it along the wall. Off the left wing and into center. Some solid defensive work in their own end with the poke check. Here we go. Puck's in deep. Moose Jaw's got possession of the puck. Slides the puck over to Dillon. Quick feed to Rickey. And there's a save.
You know the goalie's dialed in when he redirects the puck to the corner.
Oh, and a big-time hit on the play.
Well, and it's another hit. I mean, how many times is that now, James? He's going to continue to be a target if his head is down.
Takes the bump and loses control of the puck. Oh, what a hit check. He got all of that. Centering feed. And that doesn't go as it's off the stick. Moves around along the half wall. And the pass is redirected. The Warriors will play it from the defensive zone. Tries to get the puck to Rickey. Oh, they telegraph the pass and he puts it off. And there's a power play opportunity coming up here. Whistle blows, stopping the play.
Shorthanded, down a goal here late in the third. They got to look to be opportunistic. They got to bring out the power kill and look to jump on pucks.
What an opportunity here as they go on the power play.
An opportunity on their first power play of the game, James. And this is an opportunity to look at the coverage as well. See how they're playing it, whether they're going to be aggressive or sit back.
Under a minute to go in the third. That's just textbook positioning to break up the play. Taken along the wall by Rickey. Puck clears the zone. And that's knocked away. Big time hit check there. That's how you finish a play. Return pass. What a steal in his own end. And there we go. Icing is the call. Another face-off looming here on this power play. Hicks wins possession in the defensive zone. Great read with the stick. Trying to clear the zone. Oh, did they need that getting the puck out?
That's a great defensive play at this time of the game, James. Listen, when it's not in your zone, they can't score. That's the best play in my mind at this time.
Final buzzer sounds, and this one's in the books. Hard-fought victory in this EASHL challenge, and I guess the lesson in short, Cheryl, don't sing it, bring it. And they brought it.
They brought it. They were ready for this game right from puck drop. A lot of urgency in their game, and they win the challenge.
Thank you. Welcome back, everyone. Well, bragging rights up for grabs here. The challenge has been laid. Let's get it on. GM of Barn this evening, and we are officially underway. Oh, textbook poke check to turn that over. Quick shot!
Blocked in traffic.
Here's a short pass to Hunt.
Gaining speed through center, and here they come on the attack.
Lugs the puck into the offensive zone corner. Just a little too much contact and couldn't hang on to the puck. The Weekings take it along the wall. Moves the puck down low.
Oh, and he lines up his opponent perfectly with a hit check.
Brandon's got the puck against the half wall. The Broncos have it now. And he's pulled over to the ice and loses the puck.
Take a
massive collision in the open ice.
You want to send a message to your opponent early in the game, and that early delivery of a bone-crushing hit, that does just that.
Takes a shot with the stop. And they'll get a breather as the goaltender covers it up. We haven't even hit the midway mark of the period. Still no score in this one. And from off the wing, he comes up with it with both centers scrummed up. Moves it quickly over to Cappy. Moves it to the middle. And that's intercepted. Chess on the ice. Let's see how things change now, Cheryl.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how it unfolds. You get the first goal over halfway through the first period, and you want to kind of find a way to continue that pace and dictate it further into the game.
Play is blown dead with the offside. Both teams are set. We'll drop the puck here. Hicks wins the draw. Quick pass to Rally. Stoppage and play, offside the call. And sneaks in and grabs possession. Makes it look easy with a glove. There's the whistle as the puck is frozen up. Good job tangling up his opponent here. Moves it to Vetter. Great defensive play to come up with the puck.
Swift Current's working hard in all areas.
Scores! And we are tied. New game here, Pounder.
Oh, yeah, it's a new game, James. But I really like the pushback to get the equalizer. Now it's what they do with that momentum. This next shift is critical.
Getting closer to the halfway point of this frame. We got a tie game. Swift Current's got the puck here in the open ice. Takes the pass. And it's poked away in the neutral zone. Nice heads-up play there. Cappy's lugging the puck. Handles the pass. Brandon's looking to break out of their own end. And now he moves it quickly to Vetter. Swift Current's got control of the puck. Slides it on over to Hicks. Shot! Goaltender.
Even though goaltenders get set in their butterfly positioning, they still have to be agile and be able to move across their crease. Right there, that's evidence of it, and with that beautiful save.
Slides the pass over to Vetter. Swift Current's got the puck in their own end. And now he angles it across to Cappy. Here's a shot. Oh, and he just got enough of that one to keep it out. And sends it off course. The Weekings will play it in their own end. Puck moved over to Vetter.
looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Swift Currents got it from behind their own net. Moves the puck. Great use of the stick here at center ice. Quick feed to Petter. Here's a shot. Makes the save as he gets a piece of it with the glove.
His shot's come to the middle of the ice, and it has some heat on it, but he's ready and waiting for it. He's to position, and he makes the save.
And he slides it quickly to Petter. Oh, great little takeaway at center. Closes the gap along the wall. Oh, he targeted his opponent and delivers a perfect hip check. Penalty coming up as the play's blown dead.
Well, he's going to get the slashing call here, James, and it's a stick infraction. What that means is you're in a vulnerable spot. Why? Your opponent has gained position on you.
Takes possession off the draw. Back to the blue line. Cutting to the slot. Spectacular stop by the goaltender. How did he hang on to that?
This is a dialed-in goaltender. Very aware, knows where the shooter is in that low slot, and makes the save.
Hope everyone's enjoying the game here tonight. Another big face-off here on this power play. The weak teams take possession off the face-off. Makes the save with the bump. Tremendous hip check on the play. Delayed penalty looming. There's the whistle, and here's the call. Petter's off to the box, holding the call. A little more room out there with a little 4-on-4.
4-on-4 can be pretty confusing when it comes to coverage. You know that your defense have the forwards, but the forwards have to be able to contain the D as well. So it's complete defense out there.
And that's turned aside. Let's it fly! Oh, and another big stop! Swift Current's got a chance to go to work on the power play here after their penalty expired. Levels them with the hit. Puts it on net! Oh, at the buzzer, a big save! All right, time to get a clean sheet of ice here as period number one comes to an end. As you heard the horn sound, we'll be back with much, much more as this is going to be a fun one tonight. Well, let's see what period two has in store for us as they are about to drop the puck. Swift Current's going to have to work quickly here on this man advantage if they hope to strike. From against the wall into the open ice. Slides the puck down low. Hard hit, sends her down to the ice and frees the puck. The Broncos are up by one here in period number two.
And these are the games you have to learn how to win. You know that this is going to be a dog fight right to the end, and it's going to be the details that make all the difference in the world.
Oh, what a hip check of the old school variety. Beautiful. Sends it to the middle. Oh, what a chance, and he fanned on the puck. The Broncos scoop it up along the boards. Pokes it away here in the neutral zone. Puck sent over to Hung. And now he moves it to Petter. The weak team's played along the boards. Sends the pass down low. Scooped up along the wall by Hung. Sends it down low. Takes it deep inside the offensive zone. Good defensive effort to poke it away. And that ricochets off a twig in front. And called for the offside, we're going to face off. Still lots of time left here in this frame. Westwood Current's been the better looking team over the last few minutes. They'd love to build on this one goal lead. Read that perfectly with the poke check. He says, let's get physical on that play. Centering pass! Centers gliding up to the faceoff dots here. Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Long reach breaks up the momentum. A chance to get it out. Oh, what a hit. He got all of that hip check. And things starting to ramp up a little bit now on the ice with that play. The Wheat Kings get a hold of the puck in their own end. Here's a short pass to Hung. Oh, textbook hip check. He got all of that one. Swift Current's got the puck. And that play's neutralized. And he loses control here. And they turn it over in the neutral zone.
Swift Current's been disrupting play all night long. And this is because of their stick position. You have to find ways to be aware and anticipate where that puck is going to be going. Doing a great job, but this is still a close one. They've got to find a way to generate some offense.
And he takes the dish. And he's got the answer for that one. Frame has been played here. Swift Current's got a slim lead. They lead it 2-1. Brandon's won the faceoff. From the point, they take control of it. Perfectly executed hip check there. Rally's taking it from his own end. Moves it quickly over to Hicks. Great read to break up the play. Pass to Hung. From the point, looks to make something happen. Swift Current's got a hold of the puck now. The Wheat Kings have it from their own end. Oh, and he throws a perfectly executed hip check there. And he slides it quickly to Hung. Great heads up play by the defender. Passes it to Hicks. Swift Current's got the puck against the boards. Find some space in the corner. Picks up the puck. Quick pass to Deacon Poop. Nice zone entry from the middle. The Wheat Kings have it from the corner. Huge steal on his own end. Ross gains the zone. Takes a shot. The second, and this is a nice place to be here, Cheryl.
It's exactly where they want to be, and they won't want to sit back. They'll want to continue to push right through to the end of the period. They've got that nice, healthy cushion. They don't want to give it away.
Ross has the puck against the half wall. Pulls it to the middle, and that's intercepted. Pass right back. Approaching the final 60 seconds here in the second. Sends the pass over.
Oh, what a hit against the boards!
Executed perfectly. Wait a second, James. I believe there's going to be a call right there. An infraction happens.
There's the whistle. Let's get the call from the officials.
The holding call is usually because you're a step behind, James. You're just caught off flat-footed. And once you take that hand off the stick, they're going to call it.
Opponent. Been a fun night in the barn as we bring an end to period number two, and there's still 20 more minutes of action to go here in regulation. Third period. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to EA Sports. The final frame looms here as the officials set to drop the puck on period number three. Brandon's won the opening draw, and their power play rolls on. Swift current's penalty killers get a hold of it. Brandon's got the puck along the boards.
Not trying to take your job, James, but I have to mention that big hit. Wow, that was a ringer.
Off his stick. Stones him on the play. Handles the puck.
Swift current's got possession while undermanned.
And that's a solid clearing attempt on the play.
The Wheat Kings don't have time on their side with this power play running out. Brandon's got the puck along the wall. Trying to clear. Considered a win for the penalty killers as the power play fails to execute.
Well, that power play needs to have more urgency. All perimeter movement. Someone has to pay the price and get to... Oh, well, there's going to be a call on that one, James.
Play whistle dead. Penalty coming up.
Well, the game is played at such fast rate that sometimes you want to slow your opponent down, but if you take too much ice, it's going to be an interference call.
They'll go back to work on their special teams.
They haven't scored on the power play yet, but they have another opportunity. The key to this one, gain possession so they can set up.
Grabs the puck and moves on out here at this man advantage. The Broncos looking against the half wall.
And the puck stopper hangs on to get a breather here for the team.
Power play set to roll on as the centers get ready for the faceoff. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Swift current's got a hold of it along the wall. Here's a shot. Oh, a solid save by Wall. They get it out of the defensive end. From their own end, trying to kickstart this power play. There's the whistle. We've got an offside. Hung's ready for the draw as they continue to be shorthanded here. Swift Currents won it. And he takes the pass. Feeds it over on the attack. And a smart heads-up read to come up with the puck. Swift Currents got it now. And a stick in the lane ends that threat. Man advantages up. Both teams back to even strength.
Well, being on a power play is a privilege, James. Trust me, I know. I was never on it. When you get out there, you have to have some urgency and find a way to get it to the middle of the ice and get some opportunities on net. There was none of that.
Off the draw, and he ties up his opponent. Oh, what a hip check. He lined it up perfectly. Sends the puck across. And he came up with a solid stop on that play.
Shesterkin's had a solid night between the pipes, James. I mean, he's done everything he could to stop the puck, as indicated by his save percentage, but his team has also been really strong. Got the confidence of their netminder, and they've created a ton of opportunities.
And that's offside, stopping the play. Brandon's been... team tonight, in my opinion, but still, they trail here in the third period despite having the advantage in shots. And they win that draw at center. Broken up in the neutral zone by Vetter. Swift Current's got control of it now from their own end. Here's a chance to make something happen inside the neutral zone. Picks up the puck in his own end. Caffey's stick handling in his own zone. They've got numbers! To point blank! Quick stop by Wall! And that's broken up with a stick in front. Centering feed! And that's blocked in front! Snaps one on net, and that's deflected off someone in front. Right up the gut into the offensive end. Centering feed!
corner of the offensive end. Good heads-up play in the defensive zone. Feeds it down low. Brandon's got it along the wall. And the shot dies in the traffic jam. Oh! Moves it to the middle. It scores! What a play! The Broncos continue to bring up the score here in period number three.
Well, it's just been a terrific collective effort. Now they're on the home stretch, and the coaching staff has a real opportunity to utilize their bench, rest their star players, and this is critical when you're in a long season.
The Broncos are having themselves a night, and they probably don't want this one to end, Pounder.
Nah, I wouldn't. If you're padding the stats and you're putting up these kind of numbers, I mean, from start to finish, they've imposed their will on their opponent.
From the left side, he moves it up ahead.
Happy's been fantastic in terms of distributing the puck tonight, James. Not a shot-first mentality, but a pass-first mentality. His awareness is off the charts.
Puck grab by Benner. Brandon's going on the attack as they gain the zone. There's another hit on the play.
He's going to feel terrible tomorrow, James. Over and over again, he's been throttled.
Moves it to Cappy. Oh, a save by Wall.
Oh, goaltenders love the butterfly as he drops and slides across the crease. He makes the save.
And he denied that opportunity.
He does a great job of having sound positional play based on where the puck is on that low inner slot. And he makes himself big, takes away the holes, and makes the save.
Slides the puck to Cappy. The Broncos carry it along the wall. Oh, and he delivers a thunderous hit check. Brandon's got it from behind the net. Takes the puck. Thunderous hit check on the play.
Ross is really laboring through something out there, James, but he's going to persevere and try and finish the shift.
The weak teams are across the line and into the offensive end. And the fans on their feet recognizing a solid victory here in front of them. Oh, what a hit check on the play. He delivered that perfectly. There it is. Well, there'll be smiles all around in one locker room tonight following this EASHL challenge.
Anytime it's a challenge, you know there's a lot on the line, in particular the bragging rights, and you can see it in the body language right there. They're pretty content with this victory.
Thank you. been thrown down. The challenge laid. Who's up for it? Time to find out. Centers both set to dig on in, and we are about ready to go. The Broncos have won the draw, and we are now underway. From the defensive zone, they move the puck around. Nice speed as center moves up ahead now. Oh, what a hit check he got on that! And he shuts the door again! Penalty coming up here.
Well, she's frustrated with this call. She knows that she didn't keep her feet moving, and when you sweep the feet out of your opponent, you're going to get it all day long.
Man advantage takes to the ice. It's our first opportunity to get a glance at the special teams unit.
First power play of the game and an opportunity to go up by one, and analytics will tell you.
The Broncos crowd has really come to life here early in this first period after that goal.
Any time that you're sitting in the room before the game, you know there's all that energy. Well, they corralled it, and it has just exploded all at the same time with an absolutely electric start getting on the board early in the opening period.
Here's it on net. Big time hit check there. That's how you finish a play. Let's move to the middle.
Just twisted like a pretzel as he's manipulating and showing those silky mitts and then finally puts it away.
The Broncos win the draw here in the neutral zone. Feeds the puck across to Ross. Makes a save! Gets a piece of it with the glove. He tries to tuck it in! Made that stop.
Does a great job with some great pushes to get to the top of his crease and make the save from a high danger area.
Along the half wall with the puck. And that's out of reach and out of the offensive zone. Swift Current's got the puck behind the net. Moves it up. Oh, love the defensive stick work there to poke that one away. Quick feed to Ross. Here's the pass. He scores! Swift Current's taken full advantage of their scoring opportunities with a comfortable lead here in the first. The Broncos win the faceoff. Feeds the puck over to Hicks. Great poke check on the reach. Medicine Hat's got the puck in their own end. On the attack along the boards. And that was stopped. Ref blows the whistle as the puck's covered up. Nearing the midway mark of the period, Swift Current's got a 3-goal lead. Off the draw, and a nice job locking up his opponent. There's the whistle, we got an offside. Swift Current's opened things up here in the first as a result of their offense tonight. Medicine Hat's going to start off with the puck here in the neutral zone after winning that faceoff. Pass stolen in the open ice. Offside the call. We'll get a reset. And the centers glide towards the dot here as we got a face-off set to go. And they grab possession of the puck after that center ice face-off. And that pass attempt is deflected. Oh, and he lines up his opponent perfectly with a hit check. And that one's turned away. Oh, he targeted his opponent and delivers a perfect hip check. Here's a chance. Picked off by Messier. And that one's picked off. Stars! And look who's out of the can. They are really turning up the heat.
So creative and free. And the reason why you can play free, because you're playing with a ton of confidence, not afraid to put the puck to the net and, of course, retrieve it.
Swift Current's offense has been on fire to start this one, and still lots of time left in the first. Takes the puck. Here's a short pass to Ross. Loves the puck into the corner of the offensive zone. Centering feed. Oh, and he whiffs on it. And that's just out of reach. Oh, great core strength to hang onto the puck after that. And we'll get a breather here with offside the call. More than half the period has expired. The Broncos are on the cusp of making this a blowout, leading by four. Biggs wins the draw at center. Medicine Hat's on the attack. And they keep the pressure on. Moves it over to Ross. Here's a chance in front. And that doesn't go as it's off a stick. Tate's got the puck and he's going to hang on. Swift Current's got the lead here in the first as they have been the more dominant team in the offensive area. The Broncos win the draw and they go on the attack here in the offensive zone. He was locked in there. And he takes the feed. And that's a great heads up in the defensive zone to force the turnover. Shot! And that's blocked in traffic. Big stop by the goaltender right in front.
That's what we call a ready goalie, James. Ready for anything. The pass across and to be able to steal one.
We get a stoppage in play. Almost anarchy in front of that net.
Well, there certainly is. It was chaotic as the Ozone possession time is certainly up. They needed this rather for the great play by the tender.
We got a face-off coming up here in the offensive end.
And the goaltender looks fatigued, James. So the best medicine right now for them is to find a way to put the puck to the net.
And we've got it offside with a face-off looming. Swift Current's taken advantage of their opportunities offensively so far here in this first. More shots, more goals. Takes possession of the puck off the draw. From center they get into the attacking area. And that puck leaves the zone. Grabs it in his own end. Takes the feed. Sends it over. Can't get it to go. A simple stop with the glove by Tate. Moves it quickly over to Pack Daddy. Gets a piece of it to keep it out. From the boards, he takes that pass. And that's blocked. Takes control of the puck. You'll need more than that to beat him. Sends one up to Cappy. There's the end of period number one. Both teams will grab a quick breather. You can grab a hot dog, and we'll be back with second period action in moments. Period number two set to go here. Officials moments away from dropping the puck. Here we go. Lots of time left in this one, but certainly a lopsided affair to this point. Well, Cheryl, how do you sum this one up through the first 20 minutes?
Medicine Hat's got to change everything about that abysmal first period, James. No one will be happy with it, in particular their feet. What I mean by that is they just didn't have their skating legs, and they weren't first to the puck, which means they were on their heels all over the ice. Someone, something has to change in the second period to create some kind of momentum.
Huge play in his own end to come up with the puck. Tracks it perfectly in the offensive end. Quick pass to Biggs. Swift currents grab a hold of the puck. Pushes it across to Cappy. We got a delayed penalty coming up. That trip right in front of the official's eyes. Can't get away with that.
I always hated to play in these games. It just came out flat. Nothing you did made it better. Now they got to kill off a penalty when they're getting blown out. Real tough game.
Nice job tying up his opponent. And can't redirect it into the net.
You got to get a shot on that, James. You get in tight, you have an opportunity in that scoring area, and you don't even get a shot on that. Not good enough.
Nice poke check. And it's a quick pass to Ross. And they cough it up in the neutral zone. Picked off. Moves the puck over to Ross. And that's poked away. And it doesn't reach the net because it goes out the stick.
Fights to get tight to the net here, and it's all about accuracy and a quick release. It's not about how hard it is, and he doesn't miss.
Swift Current's been the dominant team tonight, and look at the score here, but I think it starts from the back end there, Cheryl.
Well, really, Doug, this has been a clinic in terms of a 200-foot game. You got to protect your goaltender and take care of your own zone if you want to get going north, and that's exactly what they've done, and they've generated a ton of chances creating their offense out of the rush.
Tremendous hip check on the play. Biggs draws a penalty. Looks like a slashing call coming up here. Moves the puck along the half wall. Let's see the call here. Higgs is nabbed for the slash on the play. The Tigers will have a chance to get on the power play for the first time this evening.
An opportunity on their first power play of the game, James. And this is an opportunity to look at the coverage as well. See how they're playing it, whether they're going to be aggressive or sit back.
Trying to clear the puck, and he moves the puck across the blue line out of the defensive zone.
Medicine Hat's got to find a way to stop chasing the game, and the first thing they
scores, and they capitalize with the extra player on the ice, and it's a power play goal.
While using the advantage of having extra ice available to them, James, that's why their most skilled players are on the ice. That one's executed to perfection.
Medicine Hat's apparently just shown up for this one here, Cheryl.
Yeah, they get on the board after being shelled all game. They haven't had many shots on net either, but now they've got to find a way to be aggressive, play physical, and really send a message. The mindset has to change here. Listen, they've got nothing to lose. They might as well go for it and attack.
Jordan's got the puck in his own zone. Here they are on the attack. Tonight was a blocker.
Sirkin's done a good job making that save, especially because it's been a quiet night for him. It's been an offensive explosion in the other end, but when you're faced with a save, you have to make it. You don't want to open the door for your opponent.
Great pass off the boards. Here's a chance. Oh, and he just gets a piece of it to keep it out. Takes the puck along the boards. Here's a chance. Sends it in front. And that's forces the turnover in the defensive zone. Fires it and makes the save. Moves it to Ross. Oh, what a hip check of the old school variety. Beautiful. We got a stoppage. Let's get the call. Jordan's getting called for tripping on the play.
Listen, a power play, you want to make sure that you're getting a high percentage shooting shot. And that's exactly what they did earlier on the 1-3-1 where they were able to capitalize. It's about opening up lanes, getting the coverage to move around, and then firing and executing when you have it.
Grabs the puck and looks to make something happen. Centering feed! And that goes off a stick. Puck picked up in the open ice. Oh, making his presence felt with a hit. It's a 2-on-1.
positive pass.
Oh, and the rush comes to an end after that block. Big slides into the faceoff dot, and they'll continue to try to kill off this penalty. Hicks wins the offensive zone faceoff, and here we go. And that goes off someone in front and doesn't reach the net. Shot! Kick save! Oh, great one at that. And he'll opt to play the puck here. And now he passes up to Cappy.
Gordon's up and ready to get back on the ice. With a comfortable lead, James, some would say that that power play really wasn't a big deal, but I would say different. It's really important that you push, you continue to work on your habits, because the timing could be different next time. Ross has that shot mentality. He's got 2 goals in the game. You know he's going to take it anytime he gets it. He's looking for the hat.
That opportunity is rejected. Delayed penalty coming up here by the official. Centering pass. He scores! What a goal! Medicine Hat's got to find a way to build on this now. This is the time.
It certainly is, James, and that's something to build off when you get a goal. You can't sit idly by like you have all game. You have to find a way to execute and create some momentum and more offense if they want to get back in the game.
Quick feed to Ross. The Tigers get a hold of the puck in their own end. Quick shot, and he makes the save. And we'll get the whistle after the goaltender hangs on. Swift Current's looking to carry this sizable lead here into the second intermission. They have been the dominant club tonight. Snatches the puck with the two centermen locked up. The Tigers have it against the wall. Blocked in traffic. A chance of the rush here.
Kids might say, Cheryl, they're falling out there here in period number two.
Just loving it out here, James. I mean, they have had control of the play. They've been so dominant. It almost feels effortless. And when it feels effortless, you don't want it to stop. And they've got the intermission in, and you know they want to stay on the ice.
And that's picked off in the defensive end. And there's the horn bringing the second period to an end. All right, they say three is the magic number. Period number three is coming up next. Welcome back, everyone. Both teams lined up at center ice, and we are ready to get this third period underway. Curious to see if there was any message sent in the room in that second intermission, because it has been a blowout thus far. I wonder if they might even just run the clock. Stoppage in play as we get an offside. Swift Current's been a dominant force offensively. Plenty of quality scoring opportunities, and they lead it big time early in the third. He grabs the puck here at the point. Good heads-up defensive play as he extends the stick. Medicine Hat's got a hold of the puck now. Slings the feed in front! And he shuts down a great scoring chance there. Oh, and he makes another save! On the wraparound! Swift Current's got the puck. Slides the puck ahead into the neutral zone.
Ross looks like a magician out there with a puck on his stick. I mean, he is manipulating his opponent to open up lanes and threading the needle to his teammates. A reason why his team is leading, and he has multiple assists.
The Broncos have been active all night in the offense. offensive zone, and they lead it here in this third. And as the puck is dropped, they win the draw here inside the defensive zone. Now a quick pass to Cappy. Into the corner of the attacking area. Medicine Hat's looking to break out of their own end. Here's a short pass to Pac Daddy. Scores! And that's three! It's a hat trick here on the road!
Well, old hat for him in a way, because it's a business-like approach as he's on the road. He just says, yeah, just bring it. I mean, gets a hattie to boot.
Medicine Hat's fan base watching, streaming, taking this one in wherever, probably wondering, where was this earlier?
Yeah, it's frustrating for an athlete when you know what you can play like, you know what your team can play like, you just don't perform. But late in the game here, they need goals. They need a pile of them if they even want to have an opportunity to get their tender out of the net.
Oh, smart heads up play to poke that one away. Here they come on the attack. He got all that hit. Swift Current's got the puck inside the defensive zone. And that's poked away by Messier. Inside his own end, moves the puck. Moves it quickly over to Biggs. Takes the shot. Big blocker stopped by Shesterkin. Hicks moves the puck. Can't get a hold of that pass. Hicks setting up against the wall. Medicine Hat's got the puck. Looks like there's a delayed penalty being called here by the officials. The Broncos have been handed two for interference. Another power play opportunity coming up here.
Well, they've worked on this setup in practice on the power play. It's already worked for them this evening, James. You can certainly see the confidence that they have in this particular setup. And man, is it ineffective.
Takes that pass back at the point. From a bad angle. And that goes off course off a body. And a poke check knocks the puck away. Trying to gain a step. But Myers on the breakaway. Ross will play it from the side. Nice save from point blank range.
The goaltenders are the last line of defense for a reason. This time, he bails his team out.
Oh, tremendous save on the one-timer. He's off.
And there's a whistle after that. Time shot. I think it busted the glass.
Yeah, it didn't shatter, though. It's amazing today with the new technology of the sticks and the way these players shoot the puck that it didn't just blast and shatter and explode. Instead, it's a crack, so the maintenance crew will come out and they'll just replace the panel.
Knocked away. Quick pass to Pac Daddy.
Score!
With authority.
Well, we all knew that was coming. How does he have that much time and space? I mean, he is teed up. He is locked and loaded for that delivery, and he makes no mistake, as he usually does.
Centers gliding up to the faceoff dots here. Good read by the winger as the two centers tie up. Shot! And that goes wide. Picks up the puck. Oh, what a hit. He got all of that hip check.
Cappy's looking pretty banged up out there, James. I'm not sure if he's going to finish the shift.
And the traffic jam in front blocks the shot. Feeds it up ahead.
Cappy's already got three goals in the game. I never had these, James, but it's got to feel pretty good.
Moves it to Hicks. Oh! He scores! And he's not done yet! Whoa!
No!
The Broncos have looked sharp tonight. Lots of pucks on net and a lot of goals as a result. Cappy's moving the puck through his own zone. Ross looks around. Good defensive stop with the poke check. The center again! And he denies that great opportunity there. A feed out cross! Yes! Scores!
showing no signs of let up here in this third period.
Well, they've had such an impressive performance, James. It's been dominant in all areas of the ice, and there's been no lag or no let up. The message has been clear by the coaching staff as well as everyone on the bench. Keep pushing.
Quick feed to Ross. Here's a chance! Medicine Hat's got it in their own zone. And that's broken up. The Broncos gain control of the puck. Exploring options here inside the defensive zone. Icing is the call. We'll get a reset. Swift Current's offense has not been a problem tonight. They put a lot of shots on net and lead it big time late in this third period. Babes wins it in the offensive zone.
The pressure's on the defensive side of the puck. They win it clean, and they have an opportunity right away with the tired group that they're playing against.
Play set to resume with the faceoff ready to go. Medicine Hat's won the draw. Now let's see what they can do with it. Rips it, and the lane's clogged up blocking that. Here's a short pass to Hicks. Sends it over to Cappy. Here's a chance. He scores! And there's the hat trick, and let those shovels fly.
Anytime you get a hat trick, it's a special moment for a player, an athlete here, James. But to do it at home and have all of those caps fly out on the ice, it's a pretty special one.
Swift Current's not far from the finish line here as they lead it late in this third. Moves it quickly over to Pack Daddy. Jordan's hauled down. Penalty on the way. Let's see what the official makes for the final decision.
Well, the penalty's inconsequential. They've been dominant all game, and just have a look at the scoreboard. This one's over.
Biggs wins it. They'll go to work now on the attack. Big time stop. Quick feed down low. As the final seconds tick off the clock, the home fans acknowledging what they just saw tonight. Pushes it across to Pack Daddy. And they're going to be short-handed once again, much to the chagrin of these fans. What is that? Is that three in a row now?
Yeah, that's three in a row. You got it. And the fans certainly don't like it, but it's not up to them, is it? Now they're back to the PK. So difficult to get any kind of flow in the game when you march into the penalty box.
It is all over.
Cheryl, these are one of those games where it's fist bumps and high fives for everybody, isn't it?
It certainly is. When it's working, it's working, James. This was a full 60 minutes, and the coach is certainly going to be happy. I'm not sure if they're going to have any video after this one.